هيا على الفلاح.
بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we welcome you back again to our series Perfecting Our Salat. Today, inshallah, we would like to discuss a very, very, very important aspect of our salat, which is its quality. Like we said last time, salat is the most important action of our deen. And we want to make sure that we perfect the salat. Some people think perfecting salat means only doing its, you know, apparent actions correctly, maybe learning about the salat, maybe, you know, praying the salat on time, which is of course very, very important. But perfecting salat requires much more depth. Today, we want to discuss the condition of the heart. How is your heart in salah? When you are standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, when you are standing before Allah, what is the state of your heart? Salat is the remembrance of Allah. The whole purpose of salat is to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and praise Him and prostrate before Him and show gratitude and love to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if the person is physically standing before Allah, but his heart is somewhere else, sometimes this can rather be a reason of the anger of Allah and not the pleasure of Allah. So we want to understand, where should our heart be? My brothers and sisters, when the person prays, he must be in complete khushu' and khudu' to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. His heart must be present. لَيْسَ لِلْمَرْءِ مِنْ صَلَاتِهِ إِلَّا مَا عَقَلَ مِنْهَا. The person will not be rewarded for his salat except for that portion where he was focused and concentrating in. Nowadays, a lot of people are struggling. Many of us are struggling with giving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala full concentration for a few minutes in the day and the night. Isn't that a shame? The Muslim must first have muraqabah. He must first, to get this khushu' and concentration in his life, he must learn how to be watchful over his heart. Sort of a quality control process. He has to ask himself before salat, what am I doing now? Who will I be talking to now? Who will be speaking to me now? Who will I be in his presence now? When the person gets his feelings in his heart, and he raises his hand and says, Allahu Akbar, he must have that feeling that he has moved to a different place. Full attention and full concentration must be given to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because now you are in His presence. Now you are standing before Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you recite your Quran, when you are in ruku', when you are in sujood, when you are saying subhana rabbi al-a'la, these words, they must come out of your heart. You must ponder over their meaning. You must focus over the meaning. So we have to be watchful over this heart. We watch the heart before salah. We watch the heart during salah. The first step to perfect my salah is that I look during my salah. Is my heart present or am I standing physically before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? But all I can think about is my wife or my husband or my children or work. Sometimes it gets hard for the Muslim because of his indulgement in this world and, you know, the lifestyle that we have and how fast this lifestyle has become. Sometimes we struggle to give Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala attention. So it is something that I would like to say is not easy. Don't assume that you can bring khushu' and concentration in your life just by an order from your brain. Some people, you know, it's a bit funny, but some people, when they want to bring khushu' in their life, he stands in salat and he starts, you know, try to, you know, maybe stand in a figure or take the position of someone that is khasha. He closes his eyes and tries, you know, which is a good attempt. But it shows lack of understanding of what khushu' and concentration really mean. For the person to have khushu' in his salat, for the person to concentrate in his salat, the process starts long before salah. It starts long before the takbirah of salat. It starts in your life. When the person is in the remembrance of Allah in his life, away from sin, close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, working in da'wah, or whatever he is, but he is mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he lowers his gaze, he doesn't indulge in haram acts, doesn't talk haram, and then comes to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or in his house he is praying, if his lifestyle, if his life outside salat can be worked on, then inshallah this state can be preserved when the person stands before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when you, some people think, I can, you know, do whatever I want and then I'm going to come and I have khushu' in my salat. It doesn't work that way. You have to come to salat in that state. This is why the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he even directed us to the way we walk to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The way you approach salat. You should not rush. You should not run coming to salat. Why? Because already you are preparing yourself for standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you have to be mindful of the salat and watchful over our hearts. When we are reading Quran, we try as much as we can to ponder over its meaning. When we make our takbir al-ula, you know, we think, oh, now I'm saying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the greatest. Allahu Akbar. Allah is greater than everything that can busy me now. Allah is greater than everything that can distract me from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When I'm in ruku', I remember, you know, Subhana Rabbiya al-Azim. Subhana Rabbiya al-Azim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my Lord is the greatest, free from all imperfection, subhanahu wa ta'ala. I ponder over these meanings. I try to take these words out of my heart, fully out of my heart. And when I'm in sujood, I remember the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in the hadith, أَقْرَبُ مَا يَكُونُ الْعَبْدُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ وَهُوَ سَاجِدْ. The closest you are to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is when you are in sujood. So when the person puts his forehead on the floor, humbles himself before his Lord, you know, and starts saying and glorifying Allah, praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahi, my brothers and sisters, the feelings, the emotions that might come to his heart at that moment, no words in this world can describe them. So we want to fix the quality of our salat. We don't want our salat to be an image without core, without depth. We want our salat to be an aspect of our life. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, وَجُعِلَتْ قُرَّةُ عَيْنِي فِي الصَّلَاةِ. The comfort and coolness of my eyes is salat. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't pray like many of us prayed. We pray now to offload, to, you know, offload the obligation. And then when I finish, alhamdulillah, I just prayed my duhr or my asr, and now I can focus on my life and focus on my worldly things. No. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam enjoyed standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He used to tell Bilal radiyallahu anhu, arihna biha ya Bilal. Oh Bilal, call adhan, let us rest. The world was disturbing for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So prayer was his comfort sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Prayer was the relationship, the moments he spent with his lords, with his heart sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was over the moon. So we want to work on this salat. We want to work on our hearts. We want to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us this quality, you know. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. Verily the believers are successful. They are the ones who had concentration and devotion in the salat. So as much as we can, we need to work on this aspect by being watchful, by practicing, by training. And inshallah, over the next segments, we will discuss how this concentration can come in our life and how we can perfect our salat even more.